Today is Monday, Parashat Bechukotai. Bechukotai begins with blessings that we will have if we follow the words of Hashem. And the first pasuk, Im Bechukotai Telechu, if you follow my statutes, Vet Mitzvotai Tishmeru, and you observe my commandments, Va'asitem Otam, and you will perform them, then I shall give you rains in their time. And the land will yield its produce. The tree of the field will give its fruits. So Rashi asks a question that the Pasuk seems to be redundant. If you follow my statutes and observe my commandments, and perform them, it seems to be repeating the same idea, to follow the mitzvot. But Rashi explains, in bechukotai telechu, what it refers to actually is learning Torah. If you're able, in order to be able to fulfill the mitzvot, you have to learn Torah, and you have to delve in the Torah and put effort in learning how to perform the mitzvot. So the beginning of the pasuk, if you follow my statutes, is actually speaking, if you learn Torah and you will be able to then understand how to fulfill the mitzvot, because lerechu means in Hebrew to walk. If you walk, it means that you're involved in the Torah, in learning Torah, then you'll be able to fulfill the mitzvot properly. And in truth, it says here, "Vehevu amelim b'Torah al menat lishmor ulkayim." You invest effort in learning Torah so that you'll be able to fulfill the mitzvot and do them properly. Then the next pasuk is the blessings that will happen. "Venatati gishmechem ve'itam." I'll give you rain in their proper time. Timing is so important. Rain that falls at the proper time will help the fruits to grow. But if there is a rain that falls when, let's say, the trees are just at the stage of flowering, then the hard rain could just make all the flowers fall and there was no fruit. So the timing is so important. So the blessing is that the rain will fall in its own proper time. But it's not just about the rain. Also, in general, life timing is so important. Saying something at one time can get a different reaction than saying it at a different time. So, itam, like it says, davar be'ito matov, something in its proper time is so good. Benatena aretz yevula, then the land will give you produce, will give plenty, there will be abundance. And then the pasuk says, v'isig lachem da'ish et batzir u'batzik yatzir kezara. The threshing of the grain will be so plenty and abundant that you'll be doing it all the way until the time of harvesting the grapes. And the harvesting of grapes will last all the way until the season of sowing the seeds, so there will be such abundance. V'achaltem lachmechem lasova, v'shavtem lavetach be'artzechem. A beautiful blessing here is that you eat your bread, lasova, your food, to be satisfied. Being satisfied is in itself a blessing. Sometimes a person can have a lot and feel that he's lacking, and a person can have a little and be satisfied with what he has. In food, in eating, in sustenance also, there is type of eating that is, no matter how much a person has, people who overindulge in food, they always feel that they're lacking, they don't have enough. That overindulgence is something that feels like you're just never full. When a person can, with a little, with a smaller quantity, when there is beracha, he feels satisfied. There is lasova. This is the idea to live in security in your land. And safety and security is so important. So these are just some of the blessing. And the next one is Venatati Shalom Ba'aretz. There will be peace in the land. And all these are blessings that will come to us because we learn the Torah and we apply its mitzvot based on our teachings that we are able to absorb as we invest effort in learning Torah. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen ve'amen.